Hello.
We all love Peep Show.
Me too. It's just as well, isn't it?
It does. It helps, doesn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
So we're here to talk about your book, How Not to Be a Boy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so funny, as I expected from you. Like, properly funny. I'm talking where you will cry laughing with it. But there's some incredibly emotional parts of the book as well. Was it very difficult to delve back into those parts of your life, particularly in and around talking about losing your mum? I know that
yeah.
stood out for me.
Well, I mean, my mum died when I was 17, and I've sort of put that in the middle of the book. And I think, not that in my huge experience of writing exactly one book, but I found that, you know, I think usually getting to the middle of the book is quite difficult anyway, because you're suddenly going, oh, I've got all these plates spinning. And
yeah.
But emotionally, yes, of course, it was, you know, in a way, she died in 1990, so I've had 28 years to get used to the idea, but it was really a question of finding a sort of decorum for the reader, because you feel this kind of duty of care. You don't suddenly want to drop this bombshell on the reader from orbit. You kind of, or indeed, you know, suddenly carry on with all the jokes,
mm-hmm.
you know. So it's just finding a tone and a voice for that part of it. And,
it's quite shocking, isn't it? Because your mother is diagnosed with a terminal illness, and by then she's left your dad and remarried. So you've got a stepdad.
Yeah.
And you've got kind of unfinished business with your mother, because you really need her to talk to you about some things.
Yeah, yeah. It was just become what felt, I mean, worse things happen to people all the time, but what felt particularly sort of cruel about it was that I was 17 and we were just starting to have that grown-up relationship, just, you know, talking to each other as friends. And that's when she disappeared. So that felt a bit mean.
And the, and